All right, my beautiful loves, let's see what we have here for Libra, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs. Clarity, guidance, and love messages for my beautiful Libras, please. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. Tell me what we have here for Libra, please. Holy Spirit, okay. Ooh, we got the Page of Wands in the reverse. Leo, Sag, Aries energy. Knight of Swords, Aquarius, Gemini, Libra energy. Two of Swords. The Knight of Pentacles, Aquarius, the Knight of Pentacles, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo energy. We've got the Four of Wands. And we have the Justice card, Libra energy. Under the deck, we have the Chariot, Cancerian energy. We have the Three of Swords. And we have the Wheel of Fortune, the Moon, and the Six of Pentacles. Okay, so Libra, let's see what we have here. With the Page of Wands in the reverse and the Knight of Swords, Libra, I feel like somebody here made a lot of impulsive promises, a lot of impulsive promises. Somebody here wanted things to move faster than what they were supposed to move. So this person said just about anything they had to say in order to get what they wanted, okay? You know, with the Page of Wands in the reverse, though, these promises are not going to actually take place. With the Two of Swords and the Knight of Pentacles, I feel like somebody here did not want to make any decisions right away. Somebody here wanted to move slow, because we've got the slowest card in the deck and the fastest card in the deck. So someone here, you know, didn't want to make any blind decisions, didn't want to make any quick decisions. I feel like somebody here may even have pushed to get married, because the Justice card and the Four of Wands, I feel like there's this energy of, hey, let's just run to the courthouse and get married, or hey, let's just, you know what I'm saying, go run and do this. Like someone here was being pushed into a high level of commitment, or hey, let's, you know what I'm saying, you know, sign paperwork and move into an apartment together, or let's buy a house together. And somebody was being very pushy about this, very pushy about it. I'm getting a very pushy and persistent energy here. Now, with the Chariot here, I feel like somebody decided to do the right thing. Like, okay, you know, this person wants to be with me. They seem to love me. They seem to whatever. Okay, let's get married. Or okay, let's buy this house. Or okay, I'll co-sign on a car for you. You know what I'm saying? Because I feel like with the Six of Pentacles and the Moon card, somebody here gave something, whether it was money, time, attention, whatever. And with the Moon card, it was under false pretenses. Okay. And with the Three of Swords here, I feel like someone is going to get hurt. But with the Wheel of Fortune, this is basically you reap what you sow. You know what I'm saying? This is, you know, the Wheel of Fortune is, you know, whatever action you do today, it's going to turn back around on you tomorrow, right? So I feel like someone here didn't follow their intuition, didn't follow their higher self, and now they're paying the price for it. Okay, so let's see here. Spirit, tell me about the Page of Wands in the reverse for Libra. Page of Wands in the reverse for Libra. The Two of Pentacles. Tell me about the Knight of Swords for Libra. The Ten of Pentacles. Libra, you may have been dealing with somebody that was very up and down financially. Like this money, this person, as soon as they got money in their hand, they spent it. And with the Knight of Swords and the Ten of Pentacles, now listen, guys, you don't have to have a crap ton of money in the bank. This could be somebody that, let's just say, for instance, you know, has trouble paying their rent or is living with a parent. Money's up and down. Life is up and down for them, right? And you have your own apartment. And this person wants to move in because they, you know, they don't want to live with their parents or they don't want to do whatever, right? That's a form of a gold digger, okay? Somebody here wanted things to move very quickly, okay, because things were not steady and stable in their life. So someone here was very much in an energy of saying whatever they had to say to get into a relationship. Tell me about the Two of Swords here. We've got the Hierophant, Taurus energy, and the Lover's card, Gemini energy. I feel like someone here did not want this high level of commitment just yet. Okay, someone here still wanted time to make a decision. Someone here just didn't want this just yet. They wanted time to see if this is what they really wanted. Tell me about the Knight of Pentacles for Libra, the Three of Swords. Somebody here, I feel like somebody here wanted to wait because they wanted to see if somebody would hurt them. They didn't want to get hurt. Do you see what I'm saying? They didn't want to get hurt. This could also be a representation with the Five of Swords and the Ace of Cups. Maybe one person here was fresh out of a relationship and somebody didn't want to be a rebound. So this person that wanted things to move quickly, there could have been an energy of, well, do you want a relationship really fast to hurt your past person? Or, you know, do you want to get into a relationship really fast because you have no place to live because you just ended a connection? Do you see what I'm saying? It could be an energy of somebody here is trying to get out of a relationship and clinging to somebody else. You understand? Yeah, you understand? So let's see here. It doesn't have to be. That's just tell me about the Four of Wands here for Libra. The Nine of Wands. Tell me about the Justice card for Libra and the Judgment card. Libra, somebody here is going to wear down the person that wants to wait, okay? Somebody here is going to wear them down. So if this person wants to run to the courthouse and get married, they're going to wear you down. If someone here wants you to sign a lease for an apartment or a house or a car or something along those lines, they're going to wear somebody down, okay? Because they are looking, see with the Two of Pentacles, someone's life is very up and down and unstable, and they want that Four of Wands stability energy. Do you see what I'm saying? Tell me about the Chariot for Libra. We've got the Moon card, Cancer, Piscean energy. Tell me about the Three of Swords and the Queen of Wands. Okay, so you see, somebody here did with the Chariot what they felt was right, okay? But they did it under an illusion, under pretense, okay? I feel like this person did not follow their intuition. Did not follow their intuition. With the Three of Swords and the Queen of Wands, Leo, Sag, Aries energy, I feel like somebody here promised the world, and now with the Three of Swords and the Queen of Wands, somebody here maybe is cheating, or somebody here has a third party, okay? Somebody here was really pushing for a relationship, Libra, really pushing for marriage or to move in together, and once they got comfortable where it was stable and they had that person on lockdown, now they're cheating with a third party. Tell me about the Wheel of Fortune for Libra. The Wheel of Fortune for Libra. The Two of Cups. Tell me about this two and the Six of Cups. Libra, this person wanted to be Emperor, Empress. This person wanted to be committed. And now with the Four of Cups and the Seven of Cups, you're left feeling lonely, confused, not understanding what the hell is going on here. I feel, Libra, that someone here gets taken advantage of because somebody here needs something. And there's a sense of, I know I shouldn't do this. This person has gotten out of, I feel like someone here has gotten out of a relationship too quickly, okay? Like someone here just got out of a relationship and they come to you and they say, no, 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 let's move in together. I want to get married. I want to do this. I want to do that. I want to do all these things. And you're like, dude, you need a minute to like heal or whatever the case may be. And this person doesn't want to hear it. No, 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 no. Let's go. Let's get married. Let's move in together. Let's put ourselves on Facebook and Instagram. I want to show the whole world we're together and we're together. And there's a sense of, I think you need to slow down because I feel like I'm going to get hurt here. You know what I'm saying? But this person's so persistent that the person gives in and says, okay. Okay, if you love me that much and you really want to move in and you want to get married, okay. You know what I'm saying? But someone doesn't follow their intuition and this person ends up back with their ex. Okay, because this ex is a soulmate, this ex is their destiny, this ex is where they're supposed to be. And that is why the person that was being pushed into a relationship had this overwhelming feeling of, we shouldn't do this, we shouldn't do this, because somebody knew and felt it inside that this isn't right. Okay, and because someone here didn't follow that intuition, they ended up, you know, with the Moon card and the Six of Pentacles, maybe losing money, or, you know, like somebody here maybe got stuck with an apartment that, this expensive apartment that they didn't need, and now they have to pay the rent. You see what I'm saying? Like, someone here loses because they didn't follow their intuition. We've got codependency. Addictions are affecting your romantic life. We've got unrequited love. There's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. We've got deception. Someone is wearing a false mask in this relationship. Yep, see, someone here is super passionate about getting into a relationship with you, with engagement, just to then leave you and separate. It's like they were so quick. Let's get into this relationship, like so fast, just to then leave you to go back to the ex. Okay, so just be careful with that. All right, I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon.